August 9th, 2017, and we are very excited to have in the studio with us today, Nicole Atkins. Take it away whenever you're ready.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah. This song is called Darkness Falls So Quiet. is a broke down look. Intuition, blind ambition, just a roll of the dice. Chasing blue skies, no compromise against all words of advice. Everything I ever wanted, I can see it, and even taste it. Almost can reach it.
Audio Tree Live with Nicole Atkins. Thank you guys so much for being here. It sounds amazing.
Thanks.
Thank you for coming in after your show at Space last night before continuing on your tour.
Yeah.
And it doesn't only sound good, it also looks incredibly cool. All of you guys are the coolest people I've like ever seen in my life.
That's all we want.
Well, then you're achieving it. But you, I know that we were talking earlier, and I know you came from a very cool place in terms of starting your music career.
Yeah.
You started in the early 2000s in New York City.
Yeah.
So this is a broad question, but tell me everything.
Well, I'm from Asbury Park, New Jersey. Mm-hmm. So I never thought that I would ever go to New York because I was like, oh, New York, it's so stressful.
Yeah.
And a friend of mine was a songwriter, and he was like, oh, come to this open mic at the Sidewalk Cafe. Mm-hmm. And I went there, and, you know, I think I pulled, like, number 40. And this was, like, in year 2002. And I walked in, and it was just crazy. It's like I met the Moldy Peaches. There were some of the Strokes hanging out. Langhorne Slim was there. He was, like, 18.
Yeah.
It was just a scene.
Yeah.
And, like, after that first night, I was like, I'm sleeping in my car.
Yeah. You know? I'm moving here immediately.
Yeah.
I mean, like, so it was 2002. So, like, you said you met, like, the Strokes and the Moldy Peaches. And we were also just talking about how we're both reading the same book
right now.
Yeah,
we're both reading that book. It's
yeah,
like
meet
a gossip
me in the bathroom.
Rag
yeah.
for, like, all of my friends.
I feel like everyone is right now is, like, reading that book. And it's like, so it's, like, would you say that it's accurate to your experience?
I mean, it's pretty accurate
to
my experience. Like, I mean, I wasn't, like, in the inner circle of, like, a lot of the things talked about, but there were a few things that I'm like, oh, God, I remember that night, you know?
Like what?
Just like a lot of nights at 2A and stuff like that. When the Moldy Peaches got signed to Rough Trade.
Yeah.
You know, it was like, that was, all of my first friends were all friends with Adam and Kimya.
That's so amazing.
Yeah.
So you were open micing at the time?
Yeah.
So were you, did your like professional career start off in that time too, or?
At that time I was a professional, like muralist and wall painter. I had a company called Faux Show.
Mm-hmm.
Like, want your business to look fabulous, faux real, faux show.
And was that the tagline?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
It was a great flyer.
That's perfect.
Made in Microsoft Paint.
RIP. It's gone now.
It was doing that, and then I was doing all the open mics and just like songwriter hangs and house parties and stuff like that, and like the anti-folk scene. And I was like the one weirdo country person in the anti-folk scene. And you know, and I played at an Irish pub every Wednesday, but I would do like Pavement and Sebado covers.
That's awesome.
And so I got fired when they hired me on a Friday night instead of a Wednesday because the construction workers were like, play some Bon Jovi.
Yeah, and you're like,
fuck you.
I can't do that.
Yeah, I was bad. but then I just ended up getting more singing jobs than I did work.
Yeah.
And
well,
so
I'm really glad you did.
yeah, me too.
And I have one question that I've been thinking about while reading the book a lot. And I think the book is, this is, no one paid me to talk about the book this much. It's
well,
just,
they're gonna.
Lizzie Goodman is gonna
we'll
call me
her
up
after.
Yeah. But I think about, and like the book is awesome and it talks a lot about like really seminal bands. But did you ever feel like it was a little bit of a boys club?
It was
in
always
New York?
Yeah, it was always a boys club. I mean, it still is, and it was back then, and it always will be.
Does that frustrate you ever?
It frustrates me, but I try to just think about pleasant things and do my work.
Well, I think that's probably the course of action, because if not, you'll just like, you'll never stop thinking about it, and you'll get so mad.
Well, it's just like, are you obsessed about hanging out at the party, or are you obsessed with making the best music you've ever heard?
Yeah.
So I think that's where the boys club can get in trouble a lot, because it's like, yeah, we look cool, we're going to the right parties, but your music is shit. So
that was perfect.
Yeah.
Oh, that, I love that.
And if you think I'm talking about you, I am.
All right. Hell yeah. Well, thank you again for being here. If you want to roll into the next
one. Yeah. Okay. This is a song I wrote with my friend Chris Isaac in a couple years ago. It's called A Little Crazy.
Great.
I apologize. I'm a little
This song's called Goodnight Rhonda Lee.
I see you laughing, but you're laughing too loud. I try to find you. You're lost in the crowd. Girl, you kill me. I understand, don't you see?
Live with Nicole Atkins. I'm sitting here just standing here just like amazed by your voice. It's so good. So I did want to talk about Goodnight Rhonda Lee, which is the title track off of your album that is out now on Single Lock Records, Goodnight Rhonda Lee.
And if your name is Rhonda Lee, you get a free record. If that's your
really?
Real name.
Yeah. Have you ever met someone named Rhonda
I've
Lee?
I've been meeting tons of them now.
Oh, do they reach out to you like online or something? Or
some
come
online,
to your shows?
But some woman I bought a lighter from up at Newport, and she was like, I see on your jumpsuit it says Rhonda Lee. Is that your name? I'm like, no, but it's the name of my record. And she's like, I'm Rhonda Lee.
Oh my
so
gosh.
I gave her a record.
Perfect. I like
even that, though she might have not wanted it.
I bet she wanted it.
Who knows?
I would want anything that had my name on it.
Yeah.
Just like by happenstance.
Totally.
It'd be so cool. But the song itself is correct me if I'm wrong, is inspired by quitting drinking and sort of shifting a perspective in your life.
Yeah.
And what led you to that decision of
I just
doing
had
that?
Really bad writer's block, and I was super depressed, and I was like, where is all this bullshit stemming from? So it was, you know, people do that elimination diet thing where they're like, I think I'm going to cut out peanuts and dairy and then I'm going to feel better.
Yeah.
You know?
I don't know if that's ever happened for someone.
Yeah.
Cutting out dairy.
Oh, no, making them feel better. A lot of people. Yeah. Thayer, you don't do the dairy and you feel great. But I, I just cut out the booze and all of my powers started coming back.
Oh, that's amazing. Yeah. So I was going to ask, did it help, and are you not blocked anymore?
Yeah, I mean, I'm pretty much in the flow now.
Oh, that's amazing.
For now, you know, it's a delicate thing. It could go at any time. But today I'm doing good.
Awesome. I think that is good to hear, because I feel like a lot of people actually, going back to the book, like use alcohol as a way to sort of like, maybe it like releases their inhibitions a little bit.
Totally.
Like they're like, well, actually I'll be able to tap in more to a creative spirit or whatever if I'm having
or
a drink
stage fright,
or something. Or stage fright.
Yeah, people don't drink or party to feel shitty.
Yeah.
You know, but then after a while certain people start to feel shitty, you know? It stops working.
And it's good to know when that happens.
Yeah. I was a few years late I wanted to write a song that kind of had a bit of empathy for that side of me, you know, or, you know, that anxiety you get waking up like, oh no, what did I say? What did I do? And it's like, that girl's not a bad person, you know?
Yeah.
She's just a little boozer. Oh. So that's what that song's about.
I love it. And that actually, and I feel like a lot of your songs on your album, not necessarily all of them deal with alcohol issues or something, but a lot of them deal with like pretty big problems. Like Listen Up, which you'll play soon, deals with like negative self-talk and sort of obsessive thoughts. And it's amazing to me that you can take such huge topics and make such like beautiful songs out of them.
Thanks.
How do you do that?
I don't know. I really don't. I just, you know, I write about my life, and a good friend of mine, I remember he was telling me, he's like, look, it Jim Sclavunos, I write a lot of lyrics with him. He's the drummer in Nick Cave and the Bad Seeds. And he was like, you could spend all your time reading a shit ton of self-help books trying to be a better person, or you could just try to be a better person, you know?
It's kind of genius.
It's totally genius. Like, put the book down and just live your life and do good things.
Well, that's awesome. And it seems like,
to quote Socrates, be excellent to each other.
I love that. And so we've talked about some heavy stuff now. Now I know that so I'm just going to shift gears for a second. And I know that you're really into old Broadway.
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite one?
There's this, Jesus Christ Superstar forever.
Perfect.
But I just wrote this song the other day and I was like, what is this reminding me of? And the girl I was writing with it, she's like, oh my God, this is like Sade. And then I left and I was like, holy crap, it's Jesus Christ Superstar, but I'm not going to tell her. Hopefully she's not watching this. Anyway, I didn't name names, but there's a 60s musical from Jones and Schmidt called Celebration that I remember buying at Sam Goody, because I liked the cover. It had like this psychedelic cover, and it was a very like musical 60s psychedelic kind of, you know, thing. And it was really weird, because when we were making this record in Fort Worth, we tracked everything live in 4 days, and we were just spitting ideas constantly, and a lot of these weird jazz Broadway ideas seeped in, and I didn't think anybody would notice. And then Josh Block, who played drums and engineered and helped produce, he was like, this has some Broadway vibes and some weird jazz vibes. And he was like, Celebration, you ever hear of that musical? And I was like, oh my God. His mom was a jazz singer that sang all those songs.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah,
that
so it was like a really weird reference that I was like, I'm in the right place.
That is sort of like cosmic.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that's perfect. I love that. All right, well, if you want to roll into your last set.
Cool.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you. This last song, this is a song I wrote with Jim Sclavunos. It's called A Night of Serious Drinking. You asked me once, what good is day when careless hearts burn so bright?
you and I are not like that legendary bird that arises from ash. We burn and crash. You asked me once, what good is love? If hurt is just around the bend, you and I play hide and seek so very well, and the game never ends in a spell. You asked me once, when will it end? These funny little ups and downs, every disaster that befalls you and I must show that we care. A pair of
this last song we have is called Listen Up.
Thanks for listening.
I can ruin everything.
my band real quick. We're gonna go this way. So, on the keys, we got Thayer Serrano. And on the guitar, we got Stephen Cooper. On the bass, we have Chase McGillis. And on the drums, we got Mr. Aaron Schaefer-Haas, who's now gonna take a 15-minute drum solo. Ready? I'm just kidding.
Live. You can get her album Goodnight Rhonda Lee. It is out now on Single Lock Records, and you can support the band and us by downloading the session when it comes out in a few weeks. I want to thank everyone at Audio Tree who keeps us going, the sound engineers, the camera and lighting crew. I want to thank Nicole and her band for being here, and I want to thank you for watching. Until next time.
Peace.
Hell yeah.
Thank you very much, everybody.